Kenya's horticultural exports were valued at 600 million euros in 2007, with exports of cut flowers being valued at over 300 million euros. The horticultural sector provides employment to thousands of people, both female and male. Therefore, the horticultural subsector is vital to economic development and poverty reduction strategies.
We are now the number one foreign exchange earner for this country. Last year we raked in 40 billion Kenya shillings, and we are doing this while employing between 50 to 60,000 people. In addition to that, there are other people employed in other auxiliary services, the transport, the packaging, and of course people like myself. And this means that another 500,000 jobs in what we call the auxiliary services. And if you imagine that each one of these is supporting a minimum of four people, that is an impact on 2 million Kenyans. So it's not just flowers for Kenya. It's an economic activity that has put Kenya on the global map. We are the number one supplier to the EU, very quickly catching up in Japan, where we have a 20% of the market share. In other words, I'm saying that it is an important economic activity for Kenya that has put us into the international global trade for flowers.
Export production of roses and other floriculture products, as well as fresh vegetables, are the most important products within this subsector. Roses are the most important cut flower produced in Kenya, both large and smaller roses varieties. Over the years, Kenya has gained the reputation as a reliable supplier of high-quality roses and other horticultural produce that is generally free from quarantine pests and diseases. But recently, the export-oriented horticulture sector got confronted with an increase in number of interceptions by European Union phytosanitary inspection services. The consequences can be very detrimental. What led to the interceptions?
At the marketplace, we faced a number of challenges, among them being the insect pests. And if I just to name a few of them, is one is Helicobacter amigera. This is one that affects most of our exports. We've got Bemisia tabaci, and another one which is called Liriomyza. These are in all our production systems because of our climatic or weather patterns that are experienced.
Mainly, it came around at a time when we had a lot of interceptions on flowers, roses specifically, on account of having larval stages of Helicobacter amigera, which is basically a caterpillar that was either to not associated with flowers. We used to associate it much more with vegetables like French beans and other products like that.
A program, capacity building for effective phytosanitary checks and systems to enhance market access of Kenya's horticultural produce, KEPHIS, was started to curb the challenges. KEPHIS, whose main mandate is to protect Kenya's agriculture, houses KEPHIS, working in partnership with other stakeholders.
We've to work with other institutions in terms of training. For example, we had the Netherlands Plant Protection Service, who we worked very closely, the Kenya Agricultural Research Institute, the National Museums of Kenya. We also had FPEAK, that is Fresh Produce Exporters Association of Kenya, Kenya Flower Council. We brought all this together so that we would design a project that then allows follow-up even after the project has ended.
The general objective of KEPHIS is to improve access for food and agricultural products from Kenya to the markets in Europe and other countries.
The purpose of this project was to help our farmers to better manage pests in their farms, and also to help the inspectors to better manage inspection procedures all the way from the farm up to the end point in this case being at our airports here in Kenya. Of course, the objective was to reduce overall number of interceptions of horticulture products as a result of pest infestations. We're very happy that the Netherlands Embassy, we are very grateful and very thankful to the Netherlands Embassy and government for considering to fund this process.
The project has been implemented for over 2 years now. What have we achieved?
One of the things was to try to develop an early warning system. Now, to develop an early warning system, you need informed people on the ground. So the first starting point was to get all those who work on the farm trained on identifying the insect pests.
Na wale wadudu ambao tunaangalia sana, ambao wanatuletea shida huko katika soko kwa wilaya, ni mdudu anaitwa bollworm ama helicovapa. Na huo mdudu unakuta ni kwamba anakaa kwa maua, karibu kwa flower head hapa juu, iko hapa. Sasa utaangalia, ukitafuta mayai, unaenda kwa mmea moja, unaangalia, unatafuta, unaenda kwa ingine, unaangalia, unatafuta, yote kabisa unaangalia ukitafuta kama kuna mayai ama kuna ile inaitwa katapila ambayo inaingia ndani ya maua, inaingia ikiwa changa sana, inakula maua ikiwa ndani ya maua, ikikula kichwa ikiwa imeingia ndani.
Swali yangu iko hapa. Hii ni maua kweli? Na umetuambia mambo ya umetuelezea mambo ya mayai, na sasa sio mayai, kuna mdudu ndani yake. Lezi niko naye haiwezi kuona mdudu kwa sababu uko ndani. Nitaifanyaje ndio nijue mdudu uko ndani?
Hilo ni swali zuri kabisa. Kitu inafanya hiyo mdudu ni kwamba akiwa changa sana, nilishawaambia kuna mayai natagwa kwa hii, mdudu mwenyewe anataka mayai usiku. Like, ukifika asubuhi wakati mnafanya scouting, mnaona mayai imetagatagwa iko kwa vichwa za maua. Hiyo mayai ikikaa siku 3-4 inakuwa katapila. Ina hatch, inakuwa katapila kidogo. Sasa hiyo katapila anaingia ndani. Anakula na unaona kama kashimo kama kashindano, pinhole. Kanaingia ndani. Bado kadogo. Kakishia ndani, kakishaingia ndani, kanakula sasa kakiwa ndani. Sasa kanaanza kuwa katapila kubwa kakiwa ndani. Kwa hivyo ukitaka ujue kama iko ndani, kitu unaangalia ni dalili. Wakati unaangalia hii maua.
The second element was to inform them on how to relay the information. And the third was on how to create collaboration among the farms, such that when one farm is affected in any given area, they are able to pass the message to the other, and therefore would be able to address the constraint. This has worked very well because it has increased or enhanced information flow among the producers. The second element was on KEPHIS inspectors. Are they competent? Do they know what they're looking at? And we've gone through a training on the various diagnostics that are important in identifying the pests that occur on the farm. Because I've said, we've got those people have been employed on farms where the produce is produced, is grown, and we have got the KEPHIS inspectors who look at the produce before it leaves the country. Ultimately, what we are trying to do is to create a channel or a chain of understanding of the pests right from the farm up to export. We find that to be the most effective way of reducing pest infestation in our produce.
Another component of this project has been to set up an early warning system. Now, essentially what we were doing under this project was to initiate a process of data collection and analysis that allows the country and the industry in general to be able to predict roughly which areas of the country might be having a particular form of pest infestation. Essentially, what this meant was that we were collecting data from scouts in the farms and our farmers who are in export traders spread around the country. This information is then sent to a central computer at FPEAK, and therefore this information is therefore collated together and sent on forward to KEPHIS. Now, by analyzing this data, we can be able to see the frequencies of particular pests that might be occurring in particular regions of the country, which of course in turn helps that our farmers are not exporting products which are infested with pests, especially pests which are of quarantine nature, which are not allowed in the markets where we export our products.
The project is a success, but where do we go from here?
The future of the KARI project, we believe, will be in upscaling what we have been able to do as a pilot so that we reach every corner of the country with the pest stations that are participating in sending the data. Therefore, we will embark on recruitment of more pest scouts scattered around the country. We will also upgrade the equipment that we are using. We hope to use the GPS system fully fledged. And we also hope that we shall collaborate with other government departments that are also involved in pest surveillance in other sectors, so that it becomes a national scope with the operations of the KARI early warning system. The trainings must go on because information is dynamic. As we approach the idea of trying to deal with other pests, apart from the five that we have dealt with so far, we shall have to increase the number of trainings that we do on pest identification and diagnostics, as well as the pest mitigation activities that are available. So we shall embark on those kind of trainings, and in order to assist us in those trainings, we shall also embark on coming up with pest control protocols for particularly some of the most problematic pests that we are dealing with.
Of course, we would not have succeeded without assistance from our partners.
We are very grateful to the Dutch Plant Protection Service, the client Netherlands, and overall the Dutch government. We are also very grateful to the government of Kenya, because it is through the government that we are able to deliver. So the government of Kenya, through the Minister of Agriculture, in supporting this project, we are very grateful. And then there is the project organization, because the Dutch are supporting quite a huge project profile. And we are very grateful that the ACEL considered this to be a very important project. And then also the stakeholders, FPIC, Kenya Flower Council, Kenya Agricultural Research Institute, and also the exporters themselves, and of course our staff. So we are really grateful for the support.
Mimi mfanyikazi wa Valentine Growers. Na scouting tangu tufundishwe imetusaidia sana kwa hii kampuni, kwa sababu tumekuwa na percentage kidogo sana ya caterpillars.
The partnership between the KARI project and the industry has been a very good partnership, whereby we have partnered through a steering committee, and in the development of the project, in the implementation of the project, and indeed in the execution of the project, it has been what you might call a real model of a partnership.